that second chance. For a break that would make it okay, there's always some reason to feel not good enough. And it's hard at the end of the day. I need some distraction. Oh,
together by Sky News.
I've always grown up with the... I wanted to play for Munster more than anything. You know. I got the opportunity to play, you know, you take it and you cherish it.
Exeter stood for something. You know, when you have someone like that in the game, in your country, like Ireland have, and, you know, it's a blessing.
Twinkling eyes and smile and great, great sense of fun.
I mean, I got my first cap for Munster with Brendan, his father. I got my first cap for Ireland with his father. So I remember Anthony right from those early days as a young fella running around the dressing rooms in Thomond Park.
They're Munster royalty as a family. They're one of the greatest families you'll ever come across.
There is a house built out of stone.
He was big in every way. He had a big personality. He had a big sense of humour.
One of the great men of Munster, Anthony Foley.
He was destined to be a rugby player.
Tables and chairs won't
die. Listen to the roar for the captain. Standing up.
he just saw the game in the simplest way, and that was to be tough up front and play the game in an uncompromising way, and that's the type of character he was.
What a great leader of men Anthony Foley is.
The ball would be thrown into the line-out. It was given off the top to the scrum half, and there was a maul set up in the middle of the park. I think we tried it once or twice in a match and it never worked, you know. So next thing, I remember Anthony Foley calling it, and I gave him a look as if to say, Axel, what are you thinking? I mean, this is never going to work. There was John Kelly went in the corner, and it was just magic.
Something miraculous is happening here today.
We just kept at it. We were relentless today, and it's just unbelievable to play with a side like that. It's honesty. Unbelievable, honest. But it's good television.
He was dropped once against Harlequins away at the Stoop, and that was the only game that he missed from 1995 to when Munster finally lifted that trophy in 2006.
An 11-year journey in this competition.
You just want to savour every moment out there. I think normally teams run around the pitch and we had a slow walk, because in the past we had to go around there with nothing to show for ourselves, you know.
It's one of the things that he was part of, was the great Munster family in that Pelican days. And, you know, he stood for something. And more importantly, he was a family man.
And now we can use another word. Destiny.
No doubt, we're going to win this one.
Can't believe I'm here interviewing you as the boss of Munster Rugby. How's life been since you've taken over the job?
I can't believe you're here interviewing me, to be honest.